فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Also, Bayqoli, we took that, sah, when we were talking about it. وَمُنْكَرُ الْفَرْدُ الرَّاوِي بِهِ وَالْمُنْكَرُ الْفَرْدُ بِهِ رَاوِنْ تَعْدِيلُهُ لَا يَحْمِلُ التَّفَرُّدَ. Something like that. I think he said. نعم. وَمُنْكَرُ الْفَرْدُ بِهِ رَاوِنْ غَدَى تَعْدِيلُهُ لَا يَحْمِلُ التَّفَرُّدَ. Something like that. هو ما رواه الضعيف المخالف لما رواه الثقة. That's the first. That was the first part. Are you with me? The second one is what the Bayqoni took, which is the second view, which is what? The hadith which is Munkar, it is the hadith, we took, there's two views, Munkar, we said that. The first one is this one, we just explained it. Are you all not with me? A hadith which has, فحش غلط, فحش غلطه, or كثرة غفلته, or ظهر فسقه. His fisq is apparent, that's one, Munkar. Or there's another view, which is what? It is a mukhalafa, the opposition of a weak when he opposes a thiqah. We said that's munkar, correct? Huh? And we said the opposite is called what? Ma'roof. We called it ma'roof. That's what Ibn Hajar rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned. Rahmatullahi alayhi. ثم الوهم إن اطلع عليه بالقرائن وجمع الطرق فالمعلل. ثم الوهم, the hadith which has وهم, which is the criticism of the narrator, is due to the وهم. We mentioned that before. فحديث يسمى, the hadith is called معلل. The hadith is called what? It's called معلل. Which is the criticism, if it's the sixth one, صح? It is the sixth one that we mentioned, which is وهم. صحيح? Is it the sixth one? Yeah? It was وهم, right? وهم, the hadith that occurs through وهم, the scholars of hadith call it المعلل. It's معلل, the hadith. The hadith is called? It's called Mu'allal. This hadith Mu'allal, we have to really listen to. What does Mu'allal mean linguistically? Ism maf'ul min a'allahu. It's an ism maf'ul from a'allahu. Ism maf'ul, ama ism maf'ul min al-'ilal. اصطلاحا, what does it mean? هو الحديث, it is the hadith. الذي طلع, it is the hadith that is looked at. فيه, in it is what? علة, a defect. تقدح في صحته, that harms its authenticity. مع, or even that though, أن ظاهر السلامة منها, even that though from the apparent, it seems nothing wrong with it. And the brothers, that's Ibn Hajar Ibn Salah, he took the definition of saying it's called what? He said, هِيَ سَبَبٌ غَامِضٌ, it is a reason that is hidden. خَفِيٌ, unapparent. قَادِحٌ, that harms. فِي صِحَّةِ الْحَدِيثِ, in the authenticity of the hadith. It's not apparent. Not everybody is able to see this. Not every person. So the hadith which is mu'allal, any hadith which you hear that is mu'allal, there's two conditions for it to be mu'allal. According to the scholars of hadith, it has to be what? Ghumudun wa khafa. It has to be hidden and unapparent. Can't be seen. Second one is what? القدح في صحة الحديث. It has to harm the authenticity of the hadith. If one of those two are missing, such as if the defect is apparent, or it doesn't harm the authenticity of the hadith, according to the scholars of hadith, that's not called illah. That is not called illah. brothers, this field of ilal, it is ma'rifatu ilal al-hadith min ajalli ulum al-hadith. It is the best field in the science of hadith. This is the best part, the greatest one. وَأَدَّقِيهَا, and it's the most, نعم, it's the most detailed one. لأنه, because why? يحتاج, it requires, إلى كشف العلل الغامضة الخفية. It requires looking at the defect which is unapparent. Your eyes cannot see it. التي لا تظهر. It doesn't become apparent. إلا لجهابذتي في علوم الحديث. Except the scholars of hadith who are immersed into this field, who know it very well. وإنما يتمكن منه ويقوى على معرفة أهل الحفظ والخبرة والفهم الثاقب. People of memory, people of experience and understanding will all know it. ولهذا لم يخص غمارة إلا القليل من الأئمة. And not a lot of scholars were able to know علل, and they were not given it. The scholars that had it was Ali ibn al-Madini, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Bukhari, Ibn Abi Hatim, Darqutni. They were ashabu ilal. They were known for this field. How does a person, Amma, what supports you, bima yusta'anu ala idraak al-illa? What helps you to know a illa or a defect of a hadith? What allows you to know? Yusta'anu ala idraak al-illa bi umur. Many matters will help you to know if a hadith is a defect in it. One is tafarrudu rawi, a narrator to become single in it. The second one is mukhalafatu ghayrihi lahu. The second one is there's opposition to others that are opposing him on this issue. Third one is قرائن أخرى, other proofs, تنضم إلى ما تقدم في الفقرتين. قرائن, other evidences, other matters that follow up the two that we just mentioned, which is تفرد الراوي ومخالفة غيري. Two other things follow it up, to indicate that there is something here. How can a person know? How can a person know a hadith which is mu'allal? How can somebody know? The way to know it is jam'u turuq al-hadith. One, it is to bring all the chains of narration of the hadith together. وَالنَّظَرُ فِي اخْتِلَافِ الرَّوَاتِ, and then look at the difference of the narrations. وَالْمُوَازَنَةُ بَيْنَ ضَبْطِهِمْ وَإِتْقَانِهِمْ, and then compare between their memory and their familiarity with this field, each individual narrator. ثم الحكم على الرواية المعلولة, and then after that give a ruling to the hadith which is معلولة, the hadith which is has علة in it. Where does the علة occur in the hadith? تقع العلة في الإسناد, the علة occurs in the chain of narration, and that's the majority. And inshallah, some of the عللs, we're going to come to them, like when a hadith is stopped as a companion, or is it a hadith which is is this the speech of the Prophet, or is it a companion speech? This is one of the defects of the, sometimes it might come as the Prophet said it, and sometimes it comes in the speech of a companion. This is a problem. Because that person could have got it wrong ascribing it to the Prophet, and he's a reliable person. Are you with me? Whereas it can be mursal in there. And here it can be what? Mawquf. How are you going to choose which one? You see? So that's the chain of narration, that one. وَتَقَعُ, and it sometimes happens في الْمَتْنِ, it happens in the chain, in the matn of the hadith. And this is very little. Such as the hadith narrated by نَفْيُ قِرَاءَةِ الْبَسْمَلَةِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ, the hadith which negates the recitation of the Bismillah in the Salah. What are the books that are written regarding hadith which are mu'allal? Because brothers, when the wahm comes, wahm is what? What did we say wahm was? Yeah, hallucination. He's hallucinating, sees something. But that person was a thiqah. He's a scholar of hadith and he's strong. And he hallucinated in that particular hadith. How are you going to know? Very hard to detect it. So the books that are written it is regarding Kitab al-Ilal ibn al-Madini, Ilal al-Hadith ibn Abi Hatim, Ilal wa Ma'rifat al-Rijal li Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Al-Ilal al-Kabir wal-Ilal al-Saghir li-Tirmidhi, Al-Ilal al-Warida fi al-Hadith al-Nabawiyya li-Darqutni. And the book of Ilal al-Warida by Darqutni is the best. It's the greatest, it's the largest, it's the best. It's the best one. نعم، and Daru Tayyibah published it. I'll give you guys an example of a hadith which is mu'allal. So you guys can just know. مثال حديث بقية عن يونس عن الزهري عن سالم عن ابن عمر عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. That the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من أدرك ركعة من الصلاة من صلاة الجمعة. Anyone who reaches a ركعة from صلاة الجمعة وغيرها and other than it, فقد أدرك. He has reached the صلاة. قال ابن أبي حاتم عبد الرحمن ابن أبي حاتم the son. He said, I asked my father أبو حاتم. He asked his father. He asked him, he said, سألت أبي عن هذا الحديث. I asked my father regarding this hadith. Because his son, remember, we mentioned that Darqutni, Ibn Abi Hatim has a book in Ilal. It's called Ilal al-Hadith. It is the son. He asks his father the questions. So he said, I asked my father about this hadith. فقال, he said to me, هذا خطأ في المتن والإسناد. This hadith has a mistake in the matn and the isnad. Allah. Ibn Abi Hatim. صاحب العلل. He knew Ilal. He said, there's a hadith is a mistake in there, from the chain and from the wording of the hadith. إِنَّمَا هُوَ الزُّهْرِيُّ. It's because of Zuhri. Sorry. No, he didn't say because of Zuhri. No, sorry. He said, هَذَا خَطَأْ فِي الْمَتْنِ وَالْإِسْنَادِ. There's a mistake in the matn and the isnad. إِنَّمَا هُوَ. The chain is as follows. Zuhri. So the beginning, بَقِيَتَ عَنْ يُونُسٍ عَنِ الزُّهْرِي. From Zuhri. It is not عن سالم عن ابن عمر. It is عن أبي سلمة عن أبي هريرة. That's how it is. That's the chain of narration. That's the wording, the hadith, the defect, the mistake that's there. The second one is قوله من صلاة الجمعة. From the صلاة الجمعة. فليس هذا في الحديث. This is not in the hadith. فوهم في كليهما. That's not part of the hadith. He done a mistake in both of them. He done a mistake in both of them. So what's happening here? That the matn has a mistake and the Allah tabarak wa ta'ala opened it for him. Ibn al-Jawzi said عن ابن حبان أن هذا الحديث خطأ. This hadith is a mistake. Just like Ibn Abi Hatim said. إنما الخبر. The narration is من أدرك من الصلاة ركعة. وذكر الجمعة. The mentioning of جمعة. أربعة أنفس عن الزهري عن أبي سلمة كلهم ضعفاء. Four people mentioned from Zuhri Jum'ah. All four of them are weak. نعم كلهم ضعفاء. All of them are weak. Another example is the hadith narrated by Ma'amar ibn Rashi عن الزهري عن سعيد ibn المسيب عن أبي هريرة. Because the hadith looks very clean and crystal clear. Ma'amar ibn Rashi is authentic. Zuhri, mashallah, imam min a'immat al-sunnah. سعيد بن المسيب الله أكبر أبو هريرة companion. The prophet said إذا وقعت الفأرة. If a فأرة, a rat falls into a sum, you know, it's not a poison. What's that? When the oil becomes hard.
Wax.
Yeah, it becomes something like that. If it falls into, فَإِنْ كَانَ جَامِدًا فَأَلْقُوهُ. If the oil is hard and it becomes dried up, فَأَلْقُوهُ. Throw it and everything around it. Just take, cut it out. You can still use it, no problem. Just throw the rat out, cut around it, and just throw it with it. That's if it's hard. وَإِنْ كَانَ مَائِعًا. But if it's watery, فَلَا تَقْرَبُوهُ. Don't get close to it. This hadith, from the apparent, it's so clean. Look at it. مَعْمَرْ عَنْ زُهُرِ عَنْ سعيد بن المسيب عَنْ أَبُو هُرَيْرَةَ. الله أكبر. Tirmidhi, who knew Ilal, he looked at it and he said, هذا خطأ. This is a mistake. أخطأ فيه معمر. معمر is the one that done the mistake. The hadith authentically is like this. زهري عن عبيد الله عن ابن عباس عن ميمونة أن رسول سسول عن فهرة سقطت في سم. How did he get it? As I mentioned before, جمع الروايات. He put all the chains of narrations together. He observed it and checked each and every one of the differences that occur. He then looked at the memory of each man, who is the strongest in his memory. So then he gave the ruling of the hadith. This hadith, some scholars, a lot of scholars, strengthened this hadith. And you know what they said? على شرط الشيخين. Because the hadith is the condition of Bukhari and Muslim. According to that. But it's not. So, ظاهره السلامة. From the apparent is سلامة. بلكن معمر دنا وهم. وهم. He's a human. Can he not do وهم? He can. It's nothing to do with memory. But because mistake that mistake comes from him. But Allah brings that imma, kabir, ulama, who know. Sheikh Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i wrote a kitab called Ahadithu al-Mu'alla, Zahiruha al-Sihha. One thick volume, he narrates hadith which are defected, and from the apparent they look sahih. Next one is ثُمَّ الْمُخَالَفَةُ. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he goes into مُخَالَفَة. He goes into مُخَالَفَة. Which number is مُخَالَفَة? Which one is this one? Who remembers? It's the seventh one, right? مُخَالَفَة. It's the seventh one, right? نعم. ثُمَّ الْمُخَالَفَةُ. Now Sheikh is going to go to مُخَالَفَة. Brothers, the مُخَالَفَة is five types. And I did mention that before. Five types. And Sheikh is going to go through every one of the types of مُخَالَفَة. Opposition. مُخَالَفَة. Every مُخَالَفَة that occurs. It's either, and I mentioned this before, it's either مُدْرَج, it's either مَقْلُوب, it's either الْمَزِيدُ فِي مُتَّصِلِ الْأَسَانِيدِ, it's either مُضَّرِب, or it's مُصَحَّف. One of those five. And the Sheikh is going to go to each one. And we're going to study each one. Each one. مُخَالَفَة means opposition. There's a khilaf, there's an opposition. Okay? If the opposition occurs, brothers, if the opposition occurs, بِتَغْيِيرِ سِيَاقِ الْإِسْنَادِ أَوْ دَمْجِ مَوْقُوفٍ بِمَرْفُوعٍ فَيُسَمَّ الْمُدْرَجُ. If it occurs, Ibn Hajar says, بِتَغْيِيرِ سِيَاقِ, the siyaq, which is the form changing, is called for مُدْرَجُ الْإِسْنَادِ, which is مُدْرَجُ الْإِسْنَادِ. The isnad, مُدْرَج happening to the chain of narration. أو بِدَمْجِ مَوْقُوفٍ بِمَرْفُوعٍ فَمُدْرَجُ الْمَتْنِ. Or a mawquf mixing up with a marfu', then this is also called مُدْرَجُ الْمَتْنِ. Those are the two, those are the types of مُدْرَج that the Shaykh rahimahullah mentioned. Let's take مُدْرَج for inshallah, and we'll go to each one after the other. What does مُدْرَج mean? First of all, اسم مفعول من أدرجتُ الشيء في الشيء. It's if you put something into another thing. That's what مُدْرَج means. إِذَا أَدْخَلْتَهُ فِيهِ وَضَمَّنْتُ إِيَّهِ. It's to put something into something. And the مُدْرَج is two type, brothers. Technically, what does it mean? مَا غُيِّرَ سِيَاقُ إِسْنَادِهِ. It is anything that the form of its chain of narration is changed. أو أُدْخِلَ فِي مَتْنِي, or something is being put into its chain of narration. مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ, that which is not from it. بِلَا فَصْلٍ, without mentioning a, without putting a barrier between it. Huh? And we took it to عُمْدَةُ الْأَحْكَامِ, when Abu Huraira, or some say Zuhri, added a speech and he didn't stop it. And so the people thought it was the Prophet's speech. Okay? Two types. مُدْرَج is two types. How many types are there? Two types. مُدْرَجُ الْإِسْنَادِ, Ibn Hajar mentioned it. And مُدْرَجُ الْمَتْنِ. What does مُدْرَجُ الْإِسْنَادِ mean? It means هُوَ مَا غُيِّرَ سِيَاقُ إِسْنَادِهِ. It's the form and it's a pattern. The way of its chain of narration has been changed. Example is as to follow. Example will clarify everything for us. قِصَّةُ ثَابِتِ بْنُ مُوسَى الزَّاهِدُ فِي رِوَايَتِهِ. ثابت ابن موسى الزاهد, in his story, in his narration, it is من كثرت صلاته بالليل حسن وجهه بالنهار. Anyone who perfects his prayer, who increases his prayer at night, حسن وجهه بالنهار, his face will be glowy and gloomy daytime, be good faced. But that's the person who increases ibadah a lot at night. In the daytime, Allah will shine his face. The story is as follows, and how this hadith, this part of the hadith, entered into another hadith. وَأَصْلُ الْقِسَّةِ أَنَّ ثَابِتِ بْنُ مُوسَى, this man ثابت بن موسى, he entered upon who? عَلَى شَرِيكِ بْنَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ الْقَاضِي وَهُوَ يُمْنِي. He entered upon ثابت بن موسى, entered upon شَرِيكِ بْنَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ الْقَاضِي. What was he doing? وَهُوَ يُمْنِي, whilst he was dictating a hadith. He was saying, حَدَّثَنَا الْأَعْمَشُ, أَعْمَشُ told us, عَنْ أَبِي سُفْيَانَ, عَنْ جَابِرْ, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And what did he do? وسكت. He went quiet. Shariq became quiet because he's letting for the people to write. So we want quiet.